One love.
Ninth career meeting between these two. Nothing to separate them, even if Lynn has been on top in recent times.
One all.
And it's kind of to start with, Neha, get your thoughts on this a little bit. It's always been a tight matchup because they're pretty different players as well in terms of their core strengths, if you like, their prime ways, you think of first and foremost of winning points.
Yeah, very different but very similar in how dangerous in their attacks that they can be. I mean, of course, left-handers have an advantage to get more wide angles, but I mean, Lee Sung-soo is just very dangerous near the table. And when he makes those forehands and just the thump that he puts from his foot, I find it very scary for sure.
Yeah, on the other hand, you feel the rallies get a bit more broken, a bit more open away from the table. That suits Lin Gaoyuan. Lee, of course, will know, they'll be aware of how to do this. They've got a big history.
You can see the aggression sitting right there for the Chinese.
First towel break.
So beautiful and so destructive for the opponent to get this one.
Table you talked about already, he's destructive. Lee, good example of it there.
And I also find it so interesting that how China has been able to develop the pipeline of talent that they have. I mean, for all the players from other nations, for example, Lee Sung-soo is a two-time Olympian, and Lin Gaoyuan has not even played once. The competition's so high. Similarly, you saw in the previous match, Samara, a four-time Olympian. Right, it's so hard for countries to produce these legends, but China has just been on another level. A lot of talent.
Yeah, I mean, we often say Lin Gaoyuan, one of the Chinese national team players, if they were playing for another country, they would have multiple appearances at the Olympics. It's just so difficult to represent China with the strength and depth, as you say, that they've got at the top.
And thus, I'm sure it means so much more to them.
Oh, that's what he does so well. He can glance, redirect. Slightly further away from the table than where Lee likes to be, but it's just as devastating.
Yeah, extremely swift in actually the receiving from the backhand side. He can come onto the forehand, make that switch, do a perfect backhand opening.
Nine, six. 6-10.
So the game points comes and goes for Lin, but three more here to come. Do nicely for Lin Gaoyuan. Looking to build on that opening game then. Lin Gaoyuan starts game two.
One, love.
Difficulty, isn't it? I mean, he knows, first of all, Neha, he knows that he's beaten Lin Gaoyuan before. We talked about that. But Lin's won the last three overall. And you can see in recent times here the matchup that it's... Talk about Lee wanting to be close to the table.
Love three.
But he gets drawn quite a lot of the time into these exchanges, I think, that Lin favours. Just take a back step off. And then it's very, very hard to hit through the Dark Knight at that point. He's so quick on his feet. You've always got to look at head-to-heads in context a little bit here. I mean, it's a long rivalry, but, you know, he's not beaten him since 2018 overall. It's three wins for Lin, in the, you know, since then.
Yeah, form matters a lot, I feel. And head-to-head, if it's way, way past behind, doesn't really matter.
4-1.
Yeah, you've got to remember Lee is 4 years older as well. We go back to the earlier meetings. Lin is a younger guy at that point. That's really, well, feel he should be winning the points, though. He's on top of the table. He still can't do that.
And a bit of a smile from Lee Sang-soo there. Serves errors. A bit of shadow practice there. Wait, let me recall, how do I make my serves again? Oh, that was absolutely brilliant. That forehand spin. He literally pulled the ball back on the table when it fell outside. Look at how low it was. And then a crack of forehand. Brilliant.
Got it! That's the point right there, though, Neha. When Lin takes up that position there, he's winning most of those exchanges.
It's just been better in long rallies. More faster and more powerful than Lee Sang-soo today.
He doesn't do it there, but obviously Lin, like all the top players, is capable of flicking away and receive winning points, serving well, winning points in a short, sharp fashion. But that's something about him, is in open play. As when the rally gets open, he's got a very good success rate. Oh, it's immaculate. The finish there from Lin Gaoyuan. To stretch the lead to four at the towel break.
Low he always stays. I mean, so much power in his legs and the thighs to take that. Just notice that, so low. doesn't get up at all.
5-9.
There we go. It's not absolutely awe-inspiring numbers at the moment from either, but Lynn obviously controlling that, controlling the scoreline as well.
Well, yet another long service from Lee Sung-soo. I think this is the third time he's made so far in this match. Very unlikely in the men's game.
Again.
Yeah, couldn't have been expecting that.
A hit, slight edge.
Back with the service now, Lynn, looking to move on to a two-game lead.
Got it!
Misses his stock shot, that.
Yeah.
Over the table, the flick. That is a rarity. Touch receive as well. He's obviously built on it here with his first couple of matches, not dropping a game.
One love.
Not dropping a game here yet, but what we know, Neho, is the fighter that Lee Sung-soo is. He's not going to just drift away here. Still a lot for Lynn to do to try and win this.
Yeah, he's surely been a fighter. I mean, he's been top in the junior circuit and then carried the flag of Korea in the seniors as well. Of course, wonderful longevity from his side for sure.
Go on, go on.
2-1. Let's 2-1.
You know, I find it so amazing, Guy, that for Lin Gaoyuan, the first receiving is generally always from the backhand side. I mean, just the amount of movement he's doing on the court, it's crazy.
Just explain that for those uninitiated or whatever. He's always trying to flick a lot of the time as well, yeah?
Yeah, like this one was from the forehand side, but generally he would move towards his forehand and do a backhand flick. So that just requires much more movement, right, in the legs.
Yeah, of course, you see it there, not to win the point, but think of the men's game, really, in the modern era, the importance of that backhand flick receive, banana flicks we talk about.
Oh, that was a brilliant serve. Slight out. Lee Sung-soo was so confused. Is it a short or a long? Can see those unforced errors coming in now from Lee Sung-soo. It's a good serve, but this third ball attack, gotta land it on the table, please. Brilliant shot game by both the players. So nice.
He's not letting up, is he, here? On Lee. She would expect really he's not going to do that.
Yeah, everything he did in that point was absolutely right. I think the long serve has been working well for Lee Sang-soo. It's just that it's dangerous to keep doing the long serves again and again. So you got to use it very wisely. And again.
Yeah. The temptation is, though, if it's working well, is just to keep going there.
Yeah.
I'm sure you know it yourself. And then you lose the element of disguise there.
Yeah, generally, especially in the men's side, long services are used to surprise your opponent. So more of that element. But if you used again and again,
Nine, six.
I'm surprised I haven't seen a timeout yet.
Six, ten.
And more frustration on the face of Lee Sang-soo. Now the game looks to be going away from him. Game points.
Got it!
He's got firm control of this at the moment, Lin Gao Yuan. Okay, game four beginning here. Lee Sang-soo. Over the couple of games, the last couple of games, he's been in there but not totally in the game, if that makes sense. There you are.
Yeah, it's like you're playing well, you're getting into the rallies, but you're not able to win the point. You're not able to finish off the rallies. Because the opponent's just more consistent.
One, two.
That was a bit of a desperate shot there.
I was about to say, maybe a little bit frustrated.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, at this situation, you're 0-3 down, you're up against, top 10 player. You want to use everything that you have, take those risks. In this fourth game now.
4-1.
Yeah, just immense topspin in that attack. Look at that shot again.
Yeah, I've seen this type of rally a few times, haven't we? He's looked so comfortable out there, Lin Gao Yuan. It's been a feature of it. Really seemed flustered here.
Got it!
Yeah. It's a nice back and flick from Lee Sang-soo, but it seems like Lin Gao has just answers to everything. He's sitting there almost like reading his mind so very well.
Remember, this is a man who's won world championship medals before as well. You expect him to try and find an answer.
Oh, what was that? Oh, my God. Spare me the heart. I don't want to be in Lin Gao Yuan's shoes at this point. Do we getting that?
Yeah, I think he'll accept that's too good. But that's the problem. He's had moments. You know, you come back to the games we've had so far. He's on points here, but he's always found himself from behind here, coming from behind doing that work. Now, again, he felt there being pushed out, just going for a little bit too much. He's been finding it so hard now to hit through the dark night.
Yeah, he was a bit displaced there. Although you would generally imagine him to bring those top spins back on the table.
Three, eight.
Oh. Caught the edge, I think, there.
Yeah, for sure. The long serve's doing good for him.
Yeah, it's been the one, it's been the area for him, a good source of points.
Oh!
Nine,
and then
three.
That from the dark night coming into the light here. Control there on that. I think that winner, that's what he's capable of. Points needed. Make that one.
Three.
Expected a closer contest than this. You look at their previous matchups. Lin here has been too good. Seven match points. And, well, a flamboyant finish, a fitting finish.